The position GL position and the color V color were generated by the vertex shader. These are passed on to the rasterizer, which interpolates these across the triangle and creates fragments. Each fragment is then passed through the fragment shader. You'll be happy to hear this shader is very simple. All this shader does is takes the interpolated color V color and copies it over to GL frag color, the built-in output variable for what color appears on the screen. The fourth coordinate is set to the alpha value, which says how solid the surface is. This is normally 1. Notice how the language elegantly understands vectors. VColor is a vector with 3 coordinates. We construct GLFragColor, a 4-element vector, by using VColor and appending a number. GLSL knows what this means. In general, the language is very aware of common vector and scalar operations. Here's another example of vector operations. Say we have an input specular color and a specular amount. We've computed a value for the specular variable, how much it should affect the fragment's color. In this line of code, we multiply this variable, a single floating point number, by a vector with 3 elements. We add this to the fragment color by specifying which components we want changed. Here the R, G, and B components are modified. The component names for the 4 elements are XYZW for points and vectors, RGBA for colors, and STPQ for texture coordinates. S and T are sort of like U and V. I won't go into all the features of the language. See the additional course materials for full references. One thing worth mentioning is that there are all sorts of built-in functions. Some you'll probably be familiar with, such as absolute value, sine, power, and square root. Others are more specific to graphics, such as normalize, dot, cross product, and reflect. For debugging shader code, the browser's debug console can often give useful errors. For example, in this line of code, I've put a representation for a floating point number that's perfectly valid in C, but is not part of the GLSL language, so it was flagged here. Sometimes the errors are a bit cryptic. In this case, the 0 should be 0.0. GLSL is very picky about having a floating point number have a decimal point. In either case, you'll get a blank screen or not much warning otherwise. I've sometimes found myself adding a line or two at a time and seeing if everything stays on the screen. If not, I comment out the lines until my scene reappears. I call this binary search debugging.